Hello friends, today we have very interesting receptor from central nervous system with us. We call it GABA-A receptor. So many drugs are interested in this receptor and we will see each of them one by one. So let's start. Structurally, it is tetramer or pentamer of varying combination of alpha, beta, gamma, delta, epsilon, etc. subunits. Most common form has 2 alpha, 2 beta and 1 gamma subunit. It has chloride channel associated with it. Chloride entry through the channel hyperpolarizes the neuron, or in simple words, calms the neuron down. Now various drugs acting on this receptor come in groups based on binding site. First group is for binding site for GABA. GABA is primary endogenous ligand for this receptor. GABA binding opens chloride channel, letting chloride entry. Masimol is a competitive agonist at this site. Like GABA, it calms neuron down. Bicuculin is competitive antagonist and picrotoxin is non-competitive antagonist. Both of them block effect of GABA and makes the neuron more excitable, which may even lead to convergence. These agents don't have much therapeutic utility, so without wasting time on them, we will go to the benzodiazepine binding site. Here we have benzodiazepine group of drugs and some new non-benzodiazepine hypnotics like zolpidem, zaleplon, all represented by diazepam here. They potentiate action of GABA, so calms the neuron down even more. This is called GABA facilitator reaction. One peculiar thing to remember here is they increase the frequency of GABA channel opening. Next drug acting at this site is beta-carbolin, which is inverse agonist. Being inverse agonist, it inhibits action of GABA. So chloride entry decreases, which makes the neuron more excitable and may lead to, yes, convulsions. Next drug here is a gentleman, flumazenil. It is competitive antagonist at this site. It gently prevents diazepam as well as beta-carbolin from producing their effects and lets GABA do its job. So in presence of flumazenil, neither diazepam is able to further calm the neuron down, nor beta-carbolin is able to excite it. So it can be used as specific antidote in case of poisoning of benzodiazepines or beta-carbolin. Next site is for barbiturate group of drugs. They also facilitate GABA action and calms the neuron down further. Additionally, when present in high concentration, barbiturates activate chloride channel directly like GABA. This is called GABA mimetic action. Benzodiazepines have no such action. Because of this mimetic action, barbiturates are able to produce more sedation as compared to diazepam. However, this property comes with a disadvantage. There is no antagonist available at present for this site. So if high concentration of barbiturates start producing toxic symptoms, we have no specific antidote to treat such patients. Another difference in contrast to diazepam, which increases frequency of chloride opening, barbiturates increase duration of chloride channel opening. Benzodiazepines and barbiturates both calm neurons down and are used when we need to do so, as sedative and hypnotic, for epilepsy, in anesthesia, etc. That's all friends. In next video, I am going to explain competitive and non-competitive antagonism at this receptor. If you find this video helpful, please share it with your friends and colleagues. See you in next video.